moments.
Amazing moment.
It shows just how much he misses being away from his family and how much it means to him to have his son be so proud of him and what he does on the ice every night.
No doubt. And it's really been a long road for Patty Maroon. Keep in mind, he's born in St. Louis, Missouri, left St. Louis to go up to London to play in the OHL, to pursue his dream to be an NHL player. So this is a guy that's gotten after it and paid the price. Now he has a chance to go back home and play in front of his son and his mom and family and friends and guys he went to high school with and put on a show, get a goal. You saw how emotional he was, and I love your point. This is one big family, the hockey family, the NHL family. Great work by his teammates, though. In on the forecheck, and Patty Maroon, you heard him say it himself. I keep telling myself I gotta go to the net. Hey, fellas, you wanna score? Get to the net. You're gonna score. That's beachfront property. Beautiful tip. It's beneath the bar, or the crossbar when it makes contact with the stick. 9 on the season. He's got a chance to get 20, 25 goals this year, so good for him. I liked him in Anaheim. I thought he was a great fit on that top line with Getzlaff and Perry, and he's having a nice resurgence here, a little renaissance for him playing in Edmonton. And on a night like this, special night for him in front of family and friends, that's what the game's all about.
And that was the goal that tied it, but how about the one that won it for Edmonton on the road in St. Louis, a place that's been really hard on visiting teams. What do you think of the OT game winner?
Nice play by the Edmonton Oilers, and what I was really impressed by with the Oilers is they stayed within their structure. St. Louis is an outstanding team. They're very well coached, and there's not a lot of easy spots to make plays. You've got to earn your ice. So they do exactly